Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Well, I have to say, that is not my experience. I know it's the gospel truth, and we need to wrestle with that a little bit. There's no doubt in my mind that Jesus is indeed gentle and humble of heart. And the servants of Jesus who capture our imaginations and our hearts embody these virtues. In fact, their embodiment is to such a degree that the saints of God make discipleship look attractive, and some of them, deceitfully, make it look easy. And I don't think that's the case. Ordinary souls hearing these words, the simple people who listened to Jesus in his time. When Jesus spoke these words to the Palestinian community, they knew what oxen looked like under a yoke. And that is not a pretty picture. Big beasts with a heavy, you've seen the pictures, right? Some of you have been to countries where they have still yoked oxen, and somebody's lashing those beasts to get them to move. So it's quite an image, really. And it's sort of lost on us a bit. And for the Palestinian people listening to Jesus at that time, they were under the yoke of the Roman Empire. They knew what it was to be lashed. They knew what it was to carry a heavy yoke. And Jesus knew that when he carried the cross, he too would be carrying a yoke and would be lashed. Learn from me, for I am gentle and humble of heart. How do we learn? How do we live? Our spiritual journeys can be pulling a heavy load. And sometimes it feels neither easy nor light. Why would Jesus choose such an image? It was so his hearers would understand. And I was looking at Psalm 145 when I was looking at these scriptures. And these verses are there, and I think they echo a little bit of our gospel. The Lord is faithful in all his words and merciful in all his deeds. The Lord upholds all those who fall. He lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord lifts us up when we fall and helps us when we feel bowed down. Our natural tendency is to chafe under the pressure of a yoke, a pressure of any sort. There are many ways, great and small, to illustrate this. But the fact is, think of toddlers. Okay, so you say to a toddler, do not climb on that stone wall, you will fall off. The toddler climbs on the stone wall. And so you're, you know, kind of right there, right? Children are like that, bullheaded. Well, I wonder if that chapter from that, those verses from Romans had something to do with the bullheaded nature of the human being. You know, the sin I do, it's very hard to read. Well done. Anyway, so then there's teenagers. With all due respect to my beloved teenagers who are here, because none of you would ever do this sort of thing. But, you know, don't drive too fast, don't text while you're driving, be careful who you associate with, don't go out with strangers. Who knows what teenagers do? I lived through mine, but it was miraculous. Miraculous. I mean, you can imagine. Okay, here's the story for you. I'm the pastor on Quaker Lane, right, for 11 years. Everybody in Alexandria knows that. And I get a call from T.C. Williams High School. Did you know that your daughter is not going to pass this semester because she hasn't been here? The mysterious reality is that we are irresistibly drawn to those persons who are humble, yet carry heavy burdens, who carry the weight of spiritual leadership. These persons' transparent Christ-likeness engages us, draws us in. Quite frankly, I never tire of seeing Pope Francis or thinking of Mother Teresa of Calcutta. Teresa of Calcutta, we think of her as this wonderful little saint who said all these lovely things. But the fact is, she was a Czechoslovakian woman who had felt a call, a compelling call by God, to take on the burden of the poor and dying in India. She had to leave her convent in Czechoslovakia, go to India, start her work, and found a community. That is not easy to do. And she picked up people who were dying in the street and took them and allowed them to have death with dignity. How difficult, and yet how irresistible. And to meet Mother Teresa was to meet this simple, humble, amazing human being. I was a graduate student at Catholic University in social work, and we were told to come to Caldwell Hall for a talk by this nun from India. What did I know? This was a long time ago. And lo and behold, was Teresa of Calcutta. And she was there recruiting nursing students for her work. Well, the first thing I thought of was social work is kind of useless in that situation. But other than that, and so she's just standing around afterwards. And, you know, I'm standing there talking to Teresa of Calcutta. And now I think, holy cow, that was amazing. I had no idea. But I'm irresistibly drawn to her simplicity and her transparency and her concern and compassion. Pope Francis, what does he do? He shows up in the Vatican and he moves out of the Pope's apartments to something simple. How wonderful, how compelling. The simplicity of that kind of leadership draws us. And we have to ask, how is it that we can be those kinds of spiritual people? Have that kind of inner peace and joy? How can we be gentle and humble of heart? That is the key to making the yoke light, the burden easy. It is that spiritual challenge to each of us today to see how it is in our lives that we are called to be Christ to one another, to have that simplicity and compassion. It is so counter the culture we live in as to be almost unbelievable. World leaders gathered at the G20. You know, what do we call that? The bullies club? I mean, I don't know how it is. But that is not attractive to us. I mean, I've talked to enough people to know that is not the model of leadership that Jesus offers. It is not the model of leadership that any faithful person would follow. So small or great, we are all called to follow Jesus in this way. Jesus gave thanks in his prayer to God the Father that God was revealing to these little ones, that would be us, the truth of humbleness and gentleness as a way to peace and lightness, to offer one another that. So this morning, remember the words not only of the gospel, not only of Paul's deep inner conflict, but remember also that the Lord is faithful in all his words and merciful in all his deeds. That the Lord upholds all those who fall, and we will fall. And he lifts up all those who are bowed.